I have hair loss. I'm 22 years old now. I'm female. I'm 22 years old. I'm having serious hair loss problems. I visited many doctors in my country, but no one can really help me as a professional. Please help me. How to stop hair fall and how to regrow my hair.
Thank you for your question. You're 22 years old. You've submitted photos of the top of your scalp as well as an image of what appears to be microscopic photos that are probably of yours during an evaluation, stating you're having hair loss and that you're unable to get any assistance in your country. Well, certainly I can give you some guidance with how we deal with patients like yourself who come to us. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years, and I'm the founder of TrichSstem Hair Regeneration Centers. This is a technology we developed in our practice based on wound healing material we were using for hair transplant. It's a non-surgical solution, and we are able to help both men and women with genetic pattern hair loss, the success rate being over 99%, and patients come to us from all over the world. So we have a lot of experience with situations like yours. So to begin with, when someone young has a history of hair loss, we evaluate first to see if there is any family history. We have recently treated a woman who was 16, a young woman, and she came with her mother who had exactly the same pattern of loss and progression similarly, and so there was a very strong direct family history. Now, when there's a question about whether or not there is a family history or whether there is a genetic pattern, we'll do something called biopsy, where we'll take little samples of the skin in three different areas and we send the tissue to a university pathology lab to establish whether or not this is androgenetic or genetic pattern hair loss, or whether it's inflammatory or scarring hair loss. It's important with women to also have an evaluation with an endocrinologist or a medical doctor, whether it's your OBGYN or your internist, but to at least have hormonal levels, iron levels, basically other causes of hair loss eliminated before undergoing treatment. That being said, it is becoming clear that a larger group of younger people, both men and women, have genetic pattern loss at a very early age. What we have learned with hair regeneration, and again, what we do is we use this combination of acellular matrix and platelet-rich plasma, as well as other elements, and this treatment is an injection treatment, and it's usually a one-time treatment. Sometimes it's the treatment is done twice over the course of like 15 to 18 months after initial treatment, but essentially we're able to stop progression. We're able to reactivate hair that's not growing, that's in a telogen phase, as well as induce the shedding of thinning hair and the growth of thicker hairs. Like the photos you submitted of your scalp, both top from the top as well as microscopically, we do regular microscopic and standardized digital photography to establish what the status is at any given time frame. Now, when people come from outside of our immediate area, and we get a lot of people from around the world, we try to get people back in at certain points, but obviously we can't see them as often as we can someone who lives within the tri-state area. But I can tell you that one of the things that we clearly have established over the many years of doing this treatment is that the earlier we catch someone, the better it is. There are people who start with hair loss very young, like a male who's like 16, 17 years old, and they can be bald by the time they're 22. The earlier we catch someone, the better it is, the more salvageable hair follicles we have to work with. So I think that since you are trying to learn about options outside of your immediate area, you can learn about hair regeneration and about the technology that we have developed. And certainly it is important for you to first establish the medical basis of your hair loss. You don't want to use a treatment for one thing when you actually have something else. So establish that it's not hormonal or metabolic or nutritional, and also establish, maybe through a visit to the dermatologist, that it's not inflammatory or autoimmune. Now, of course, those types of conditions account for 5%. 95% of hair loss in men and women is genetic pattern loss. And unfortunately, our medical literature doesn't have that much information about this, and I suspect it's mainly because there weren't that many options until now. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.